It's great to be here in the Santa Rosa and San Jacinto Mountains National Monument to celebrate the Desert Renewable Energy Conservation Plan. It's great for renewable energy, it's great for conservation, it's great for the beautiful California desert. So let me talk about what we're here to talk about today, and that is an approach that has been smart from the start, saying when you've got incredible resources, as you have here in the California desert, how do we pull up and look at the landscapes and be smarter about how we develop from day one, and make sure development's happening in the right ways in the right places, and that we understand what's at stake in terms of conservation values, wildlife migration, recreation, and the lifestyles that people come to appreciate.
So the decision we signed today covers public land from the Mexico border all the way up towards the Sierra Nevadas, a landscape of 10.8 million acres that are managed by the BLM, both for renewable energy as well as conservation, recreation, and respecting the cultural and historical uses of these lands now and into the future.
The Desert Renewable Energy Conservation Plan helps lay the foundation for the state to meet its renewable energy and climate goals and to conserve the California desert and its many important conservation, historical, recreational, cultural, and other uses for future generations of Californians.
And I think more importantly, it creates certainty. Certainty for industry, where we think renewable energy needs to occur, and where conservation needs to occur. So there's certainty for all the users about this area is now about conservation, this area is more about renewable energy. That's the heart and soul of this document, is continuing honoring the past, but focusing on the future of where we will go as an organization, as a society, and as all of us together as partners in this.